alaikum girls. Today we are going to do the next part of the same exercise that we have already started, the people of the cave and the grammar. We have already talked about the nouns. Now the words that qualify the nouns, they are called as adjectives. The definition is already given over here. Adjectives are words that describe the quantities, qualities or state of being of nouns. One type of adjective is called coordinate adjective, which is meant to modify the same noun in the same sentence. Now do concentrate on this definition. Adjectives are words that describe the quantities, how many, how much, qualities, what type or state of being, what stage of nouns. It means they qualify the nouns. One type of adjective is called coordinate adjective, which is meant to modify the same noun in the same sentence. Means adjectives, they are used with the nouns in the same sentence, and these are called as the coordinate adjectives. Now come to the exercise. In the following table, join nouns given in the first column with the appropriate pair of coordinate adjectives in the second column to make the appropriate expression. Now look at the nouns that are given in the first column. Now the first expression may be clear blue sky. Clear blue sky. That is already given over there at the end. Next is fresh and scented air. Fresh and scented air. Next is hot, dry desert. Lush green fields. Long and shiny hair. Strong and beautiful women. Strong and beautiful women. Now, I think there is some mistake over there in the exercise that is given in your book, because one that is repeated. In the second column, you can see that there is a repetition, clear blue sky. It's repeated over there at the end. So you can write these, anyhow you can write that in the third column, and then you can draw small pictures also in the fourth column. Draw pictures to describe. You can draw pictures over there. It was just an exercise that how adjectives are used with the nouns. Now come to the next. That are the points to remember. Many adjectives are made by adding suffixes like, likable and able. This is obviously a suffix. In adjectives with able suffix, the base word is always recognizable. For example, payable, pay to payable. Base word is pay, obviously. Wash to washable. Base word is wash. Respect to respectable. Base word, obviously, respect. Actually, we are doing this thing to know how adjectives they are formulated, how they are formed. While in adjective with able suffix, the base word is not recognizable. For example, audible, base word here, that is very different from audible. Legible, base word is read or read. Edible means base word eat. The base word is very different, and the adjective that is very different. Adjective seller is delicious, with each element contributing its individual and unique flavor. But a purpose of adjective, so taste yachi. This is just a quotation that is given by William Safire. Now come to the next page, that is page number 58. The past tense that is given over there. Yes, I'll tackle all these tenses in the series in which we will talk about all the tenses. Anyhow, as this is given in your book, the past tense is used to talk about a complete action in a time before now. Usually the past tense is formed by adding ed to the infinitive form of verb. For example, infinitive to arrive. Present, in present it will become we arrive, and in the past tense it will become we arrived. ED is added. The very simple form, you already know, when we want to change a verb into past tense, then what happens? We usually add ED. When you add ed, spelling of the stem can change. When a verb ends with a consonant with short vowel preceding it, the spelling will be double the consonant and ed added. When a verb ends with y, it changes y to I and ed is added. And when there are irregular past tense forms, we do not add ed. So sometimes we add ed, sometimes we don't, and sometimes even y is added. So some are regular verbs and some are irregular verbs. Again, you can form a list of past forms of all verbs used in the story, The People of the Cave. Again, read the story, point out the past tense, because the story that happened long time before in history. We don't know even the period when all this happened. So the story that is written in the past tense, you can do the practice of past tense by reading the story that is there, because it is all in the past tense. Now we come to the creative writing. This is how to write a paragraph. Paragraph writing is also an art that is given to you usually in exams. A paragraph is a collection of sentences which all relate to one main idea or topic. Writing a paragraph is an important language skill which makes the readers not only understand the objectives but to enjoy it too. Qualities of a good paragraph are scope. It deals with one idea or topic at a time. So always remember, just write one idea in one paragraph. There is no need of mingling so many ideas in just one paragraph. Just one topic in one paragraph. And it has got structure, how it is structured. It has good topic and final sentences with specific words to make the idea clear. Then again, the topic that is made clear in the structure. Thematic idea, it has a logical sequence of thoughts where all sentences are connected with a leading idea. It means whatever we are writing in a paragraph, all the ideas must be connected with each other. There should be some coherence, some connection between different ideas that are being presented in the paragraph. It should neither be too short nor too long, but it must have some connectivity. The sentences that you are writing, there must be some connectivity between different sentences. Always remember, writing an essay is different from writing a paragraph. Essay has a wider scope. There are so many paragraphs that are there in an essay, but not in a paragraph. A paragraph is always written in one whole form. A paragraph is different from essay, as we do not treat the subject fully, but instead chose only one aspect of the topic. In a paragraph, we chose just one aspect of the topic. But in essay, we write the complete details from beginning till end. Now, task is given at the end of this page, number 58, that is, write a short paragraph on If I Lived Back in History. Now, think about the topic, write down some points. We can discuss that point also while we will meet again in the classroom. Now come to the next page, that is page number 59. Now this is a very interesting thing that is given over here, that work in pairs and find out words from the given crossword puzzle horizontally, vertically and diagonally. Means there are different languages that are given. At the end you can find the words that are given. There are 10 languages, 6 ethnicities and 6 countries in this word puzzle. Now solution is also given. You have to attempt it by yourself and then you can make the solution. The words that are given at the end is Hebrew, Arabic, Urdu, English, Persian, Shina, French, Chinese, Dutch, Pashto, Hindu, and Muslim, Sikh, Christian, Buddhist, Jew, Word, Cyprus, Iran, Turkey, Netherlands, China, and Syria. These are the words that are given over there at the end of this crisscross puzzle. Now you have to find out these words from the puzzle. It's a very interesting activity and you will enjoy that. Now we come to fluency of expression, means different kinds of quotes. For example, R.W. Emerson, the period of this poet is from 1803 to 1882, was a great essayist, thinker, and a philosopher. He wrote extensively on human life and its aspects, following some of his quotes on language. It's page number 60. Now come to the page number 60. Language is the archives of history. Now what is the meaning of this quote? This is also written by R.W. Emerson. Language is the archive of history. That whatever is there in history, the accumulation of all that, that is there in the language. By the help of language, we can find out the history of a nation. Or the history of a nation and the language of that nation that is closely connected with each other. Now different quotes are given over here. Language is fossil poetry. Language is a city to the building of which every human being brought a stone. Thought is a blossom. Language is a bird. Action the fruit behind it. Nature is a language and every fact one learns is a new word. You can write these quotes beautifully in your copies and even you can display that in your classrooms. Now come to the next. This is another aspect of language that is given over there. Some calligraphy fonts are shared here for you to give an idea. Yes, font means how the words, the alphabets that are written or how the language that is written. There are very different kinds of fonts that are there in even in computer. You can, when you are typing, you can use any font. Similarly, some people, they are expert in the use of different kinds of fonts. For example, hand-drawn calligraphy alphabet that is given in your book also. One alphabet that can be written in many different ways. So this is called a font, how these are used over there. You are well familiar that there are different kinds of fonts that are used in computer also now because most of the work is done by the help of computer. So this is also over there in computer. But you can also do the practice of how to write beautifully in different kinds of fonts. This is another aspect of the language as our main topic is how to use the language. Now come to the next page. Now learn idioms for fluent expressions. Idioms are also there in all your chapters. So in this chapter also, at the end of this unit also, we have the idioms. Here are some idioms related to some religious faiths and links with our daily life. Their elaborate meanings are given to help you understand their usage. Use them in your own sentences, write in the boxes given below. You can make your own sentences, but actually you have to learn the meanings of these idioms. And you have to write the meanings of these idioms also in your copies. A blessing in disguise, something awful that somehow leads to something wonderful, is said to be a blessing in disguise. You can make any sentence. For example, it was a blessing in disguise that she missed the plane as the plane crashed. So you can make the sentences like that. An event is an act of Allah if not caused by humans and cannot be stopped by humans. For example, many people died due to earthquake because it was an act of Allah. In seventh heaven, the idiom in seventh heaven means in a blissful state of mind or ideal situation. Yes, she is in seventh heaven as she has achieved all his goals. Gospel truth, something is gospel truth if it is believed to be absolutely real and right. For example, it is a gospel truth that success cannot come without hard work. Sacred cow, this is also a very common idiom used by many people. A sacred cow is a very special person or thing that many people do not want to criticize. For example, nobody is a sacred cow in Islamic society. Nobody is a sacred cow in Islamic society. This may be the sentence. Now come to the next page. It's page number 62. Speech Act. Some basic manners of conversation. One of the good manners of conversation is that while giving logic of our own point of view, we should always listen carefully to others' point of view. Here is a short speech act to emphasize on this mannerism. A pair of students can also perform a role play on this speech act. So role play can also be done. Even if you are criticizing someone, you must be You must have to show the good manners. This is a thing that they want to say. Example, student A, so what do you think? You never, student B, what difference does it make? You never listen anyway. I was just making conversation. When you make conversation, you have to listen too. You do. Now, this is by student A. So when we are making conversation, we should listen to the other people also. Conversation does not mean just speaking. It also means listening to other people also. This is the thing that they want to emphasize. Then obviously we have the fun reading, fun facts on world languages, and there are the two important facts that are given over there. That is, there are about 50,000 characters in the Chinese language. You know that in Chinese language there are no alphabets like we have in Urdu or in English, but there are characters that are there, 50,000. But you only need to know 2,000 of them to read a newspaper. Means, to command of the language, you need 2,000 of them. Now, the other important fact that is given away in Somali, this is also a language that is spoken in Somalia, obviously. There are 43 words relating to camels. 43 words, so wide a language that there are 43 words for just camels. So these are the fun facts that are also given at the end of the unit. So with this we come to the end of the unit, and after that we will start grammar, inshallah. So thank you very much.